What's up, everyone? I'm Sam Humphries, and today I am joined by Brian Michael Bendis. Together with his wife, Elisa, they created the DC Comics imprint, Wonder Comics. Brian Michael Bendis, thank you for being here.
Thank you,
Sam. This is the first time I've heard about Wonder Comics. Please, tell me all about it.
Which you are a part of.
Which I'm a part of.
You are a big part of it.
Exactly. Happy to be a part of. This is an imprint that you conceived of and you created, but it takes place within the DC universe.
Absolutely.
This is not separate. This is teen heroes within the DC universe. You had the opportunity to do anything you wanted with this. What did you want to achieve by going this direction?
When the idea of coming to DC was in my head, everyone would start to imagine, any fan could immediately go, what would I do if I could come to DC? And I started thinking about Superman, I started thinking about certain stuff. I was beyond the moon when Dan DiDio said, hey, you know what we're having a lot of luck with? There's these pop-up imprints that are like come in and they make a statement and they're very specialized. And
there's the great, the Young Animal.
Yeah,
Gerard Way.
Yeah, and our darling friend Mike Oeming was involved in, so I was very aware of it. And he goes, is there something you would want to do along those lines? First, I thought maybe like a crime imprint, like a bunch of crime books, because that's kind of my DNA. But then I realized like my Jinx World line is a bunch of crime books.
It's a bunch of crime books,
So, but I'm like, what do I feel personally as a fan is missing right this second from the DC universe? There's teen heroes like the Ultimate Universe at that moment when they're trying to find, you know, what the world is to them. And Dan just goes, Young Justice. Like that, like,
Justice.
Young Justice. Young Justice. And I go, is it available? He goes, oh my God. He goes, Young Justice.
We've been trying to figure out a way.
Yeah, he goes, can that be a launch book? And I'm like, done deal. And then diving into where the characters have been and where they haven't been and who's been in this continuity and who hasn't got really exciting.
Yeah.
Because now I can tell us a team book unlike any other book I've ever done, any book I've ever seen.
The big question in a team book is the lineup, right?
It's the lineup
half the
and
fun,
how you
half the headache.
Yeah.
And you got some big heavy hitters, some big Young Justice characters. You got all the big Young Justice characters.
And they're all like deep fan favorites too. Yeah. Like these are really beloved characters. Like the minute I was coming to DC, I started getting hashtag bring back Connor Kent lobbied at me like every 10 minutes. And I was laughing because the entire time people were literally screaming at me, please. Connor Kent, I was doing it.
He's the people's champion.
And I did. I wanted, I remember 10 years ago online, I could whisper to a fan, I'm doing it. And no one would, but you can't.
Right. No.
Like, well, we see a passionate fan.
You can't even wink about it.
Yeah. You see a passionate fan who's like tears in their eyes. I got you. But you can't do it anymore.
They're so emotionally invested in him.
Yeah.
He's such a character with so many dimensions of emotional attachment. First of all, you have to bring him back, and then put him on a path, right?
Yeah, bring him back, put him on a path. And where we're meeting him is that we find out his path stalled in Gemworld. Mm-hmm. He got trapped in Gemworld and decided to stay there until, and where he's needed, they need some heroism over there. But let me stay here until I figure out what I'm supposed to be, because he realizes I'm not everything that everyone's putting on me is not what I am.
Right.
I want to figure out what I am. Mm-hmm. And so I'm here now on a farm. I'm
a farmer. So, family tradition.
Yeah. So it made him feel, there's an answer here.
Yes.
Yeah. So and then when we pick him up, he's right there he's waiting for the answer, and the answer is Young Justice lands on his head.
You've got Tim, you've got Connor, you've got Bart, to all scream Young Justice.
Well, Tim was great because Tim was in Detective and had a great story building that we get to continue. So people are gonna find out what's going on with Tim and Stephanie. So every issue we'll discover more and more, including the new characters like Jenny Hex. We'll have a big chapter coming up. We'll find out what makes
with guest
sense.
Artists too.
Every
and
issue.
Can you reveal any other?
Yes, we have John Timms is doing Amethyst.
Our friend John Timms.
Our friend. Yeah,
I may have Harley
stolen
partner.
From. I may have stolen.
That's quite all right.
From Harley Butts.
All right.
You saw the pages.
Do amazing work. Fantastic pages. Now I can be a John Timms fan and a John Timms collaborator. I'm very excited. And Gemworld.
Doc Shaner.
Doc Shaner.
Yep.
Doc Shaner. Yep. I love Doc Shaner.
Yeah.
It's a Gemworld.
I loved Gemworld
forever ago.
I loved Amethyst. Yeah. I thought it was a little bit ahead of its time. It filled me full of imagination when I first read it. And as I got older and more in love with the craft of comics, I look at that book and go, wow, you guys had a lot going on there. And so when I got here, I was oh good, no one's touching my favorite thing. right?
Yeah, like, yeah.
Can I take Gemworld and, because I honestly think it has as much potential to the DC universe as the fourth world, as far as stories and characters
sure.
and drama and things that could be additive to DC. And also harkens into, I wanted Amethyst on the team as
right.
well.
Mm-hmm.
So Amethyst joins Young Justice and we go to Gemworld and we get to meet Dark Opal, who I thought was, you know, a great villain character.
Right.
And we always need new villains. We always need lots of new villains.
Mm-hmm.
So we have a villain who's doing a lot of damage to the doorways of the multiverse using their...
I hear it's Year of the Villain. What a coincidence.
Yeah. So we're gonna dive in there and really unfold Gemworld, let you fall in love with it all over again.
Gemworld really has that great combination of sci-fi and fantasy. It's like sci-fi Game of Thrones almost.
It's not unlike what they did to Asgard in the last couple
sure.
Thor movies, but like they did, Amethyst did it in the 80s.
Yeah.
Like really like took the sword and sorcery genre and scraped away everything that you'd seen somewhere else and just zeroed in on new stuff. And I thought it was really, just a really great place to have a big adventure for kids who are just trying to figure out where they belong.
Yeah, okay. All right, we could talk about Gemworld forever. I know.
Are that'll they wrapping
be
our, us up?
That'll be our Ken Burns 9-hour docuseries, us talking about Gemworld.
All right, well, there's 12 houses of the Gemworld. I'm going to list them all
great.
Now and tell you their history. Okay.
Mark Russell is writing Wonder... All right, thank you for coming by. We could talk about this forever, I'm sure. And all of you out there, be sure to pick up the new Young Justice comics. Bye for now.